Hi, Javad is here. In this video, we are going to learn how to import our Revit projects in Lumion to enhance our rendering and improve it and move it to the next level of presentation. That's really easy. The first step that you need to download Lumion LiveSync from the Lumion website. This is really easy to install, so I'm not going to tell the installation process. After installing it on your Revit project, you will have a new tab, which is a Lumion. You have LiveSync, which is going to be a link between these two. And also, we have an import process. Personally, I use import process because when you are using LiveSync, it takes too much of your performance in working, especially in bigger projects. So if you are not having a big project and your hardware is good enough, you can use LiveSync. But if you have a moderate hardware or your project is huge, it is better to stay with import. Okay, before importing and before exporting your project for your Lumion, you have to step before to do the exporting. First of all, if you have RPCs in your Revit project, you need to delete them or hide them because they are not supported via Lumion. So they will be just an additional thing without any usage and they can cause some troubles. So you can right click on them and hide the category of them, and you are right to go. And also, if you don't need, for example, this site and you just want the model, you can delete that too. And for example, I don't want the parkings too, I just want the building. I can hide them too. Let me select all of them. Let's hide them by element. And this is the model that I want to import it in my Lumion. And the second step is to purge your file. It will make your file size smaller and it will be more optimized in comparison without purging. To purge your file, you need to go to the Manage tab and you have the option here, Purge Unused. Click on it and then you can see all of these elements will be purged, and this is great. But bonus tip here, if you want to have some families in your project and you don't want to purge them, create a save as from your file and then do these processes on it. Okay, that's great. Click on OK. And you need to wait a little bit. And that's great. And let's see. Let's create our export file. Let's go to the Lumion tab in here. Click on export. And if you want a nice presentation and you have some curved surfaces, you need to put it on the highest level. But if your project is simple, you can put it on normal too. And also you can collect the textures to have the textures in Lumion too. Okay, that's great. And also you can export the nodes too. Another tip is here, if your project is geolocated, let's go to the site view. If your project is geolocated, you need to be careful about the insertion point. For example, let's go to the 3D and let's see the hide views from here. As you can see, we have a project base one and survey point. You need to tell to Lumion LiveSync which are these are going to be your insertion point and moving anchor point for your project in Lumion. And it depends on your need, but I really wanted to notice that in here. That's great. Let me turn it off and let's export again. I want to export it by survey point in this point. And that's great. And click on export. Let's create a folder on my desktop and let's name it Lumion. Okay, that's great. And click on save, and you need to wait a little bit to finish the process. If this video has been so helpful so far, please don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends and colleagues. It will help us a lot to create more videos like this. And don't forget to turn on the notification bell to be the first person who will notify for our latest videos. And you can go to our Patreon page to access to our premium files and premium tutorials too. And if you want to buy some BIM related products, go to our Mesh store. Okay, let's go back to the tutorial our exporting process has finished and we have the file here. Let's open our Lumion. After your Lumion has started, you can create a new scene or you can use your existing scenes. Okay, let's create a new scene and let's use this one. And let's wait a little bit till our scene has been created, and then we can import our model easily. After creation, after finishing of creation your scene, now you can go to import in here, and then select the exported file, and click on open. And that's great. Let's see the problem. Okay, because I've already imported the file, I don't need to import it again. And let's go to place and let's select the file. Let's delete this one because I've imported the site in the previous one, and let's import it again. Okay, that's great. Click on okay, and let's wait a little bit to see our imported model. Okay, that's great. As you can see, our insertion point is our survey point. Let's zoom out a little bit and let's place our model in here, for example. And let's go to the select mode. As you can see, we have the file and most of the materials are already has been done. Also, you can move it, for example, and it's really easy. You can specify the coordinates and then now you're good to go. For example, your model needs to be a little bit higher because as you can see our grasses are in our building. But you got the point and you got the workflow and it's now you are good to go. For example, you can go in here and let's, for example, assign a material to this one. For example, a wood material to this. Let's go to materials and our indoor materials and wood. And let's assign a wood to this one. You can choose in many different variations that Lumion has. And you can enhance your rendering. I hope this video was helpful for you. If it was, please don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends and colleagues. I'll put the display in here, a playlist in here that you can go there and watch more Revit tips there. I will see you on the next session.